east of the Pennines, in the very heart of West Yorkshire, is Batley. Its very situation at the southwest of the Yorkshire coalfield led to its development as an industrial town. Of the heavy woolen trade and manufactured shoddy and mungo. By the mid-18th century, it had become a very important wool market town. Industries today include the making of textile machinery, plastics and engineering. The last few years, however, have seen the decline of many industries associated with textiles, and this has resulted in much unemployment, especially amongst the young. The unemployment results in extra leisure time, henceforth the development of many new leisure industries. Station Road was once a major commercial street with some of the most magnificent buildings in the town and a four-story hotel which has since been demolished. A few other buildings still remain, one of which is the Xclusiv Club. This architectural masterpiece was once a top-class wool showroom visited by many important buyers from all over the world. It has since changed its role. This jewel of a building is now a first-class disco. The owner, Mrs. Anne Swallow, invites you to a special disco evening.
Peter and Anne. This is the Xclusiv Club, eh? How long have you been here?
I've been here 2 years this Christmas.
2 years, and what type of clientele do you get?
Mainly futuristic and way out young people.
Yes, well, of course, we all did that when we were young, didn't
we?
And you're finding it quite successful as a venture?
Oh, yes, quite successful, yes. And, we're happy with the people we've got in the club. A lot of people don't seem to get on with these kind of our customers, but we're happy with them and we have no trouble with trouble-free. So.
Well, I found that if you leave them alone, that they are trouble-free, yeah. And it's usually the what we call the standard normal type of person that causes all the trouble in the first place by picking on them. It's the first time I've seen the place, but the building is magnificent. Have you got anything to say about the building outside? It's such a magnificent piece of architecture.
That's right, it's a listed building.
Yes.
Yeah, it's very nice.
And it's such a shame that all the buildings round about all in a...
It's a
lot to be said for the planners of this city.
Yeah. Yes, it's terrible. It's beautiful buildings that they have got around here, and they're just dilapidated.
Yes. And how many nights a week do you open? Do you open every night, or do you?
No, just weekends. But we open during the week for private parties.
I see, for private parties, and just
well
weekend for the kids. Yes.
Well, we do a kids' disco. Yeah, yes. For the juniors, non-alcoholic.
And the times of opening and closing are.
10 till 2
normally, bar from Sunday night, I suppose.
That's right. Oh, we just open Sunday for special occasions.
Special occasions like tonight.
Yes.
Anyway, may I wish you every success in your venture. And once again, what a magnificent place.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Hello, Paul.
Hello.
You're the disc jockey then, eh?
Yes.
How long have you been doing this?
Just over a year here.
Over a year here?
Yeah.
And you find it very pleasing?
Oh, yeah. I enjoy it a great deal, yeah.
I suppose you've got all music to suit all tastes, but mostly the young people.
It's very specialised here. There's a lot of new waves of alternative music.
Yeah. Yes. And do you get any trouble at all from...
Oh. Well, you get a little bit of... A little bit of hassle,
you know. It's all in good fun, really. Yes. Oh. Well, we're looking forward to having a very pleasant night interviewing some of your customers, and I wish you every success.
Yes, I hope you enjoy it, yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That's the question. I wonder if you could tell me what something about the music that you're going to play tonight, Paul.
All sorts of the new sort of alternative music, like Echo and the Bunnymen, Susie and the Banshees, that sort of thing. And we also play a lot of sort of really old stuff like Glenn Miller, Frank Sinatra, just because it's sort of good fun and it's... I think that none of the other discos seem to play, it just makes it that little bit more interesting.
That's rather unusual, playing of Glenn Miller, which I used to dance to 30-odd years ago.
It's, well, I mean, I don't think anybody would argue that it's a great record. I think it's still, you know, it's still...
Well, there's no doubt about that, and also Frank Sinatra, of course. Seems to be everybody's
favourite. It's something that everybody seems to enjoy, and because it's so... unusual in the 1980s, it makes it good fun.
Yes, and is the beat of the Glenn Miller sound, is the beat all right for the modern type of dancing, these young
people? Not really, it's very different. I think that's what it is. Yeah. I think it's because it's so sort of jazzy different that it applies today.
We'll look forward to seeing that very much.
I hope you enjoyed it with
Glenn Miller. Yes, thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Hello, good evening. Have you got a ticket? It's a private function tonight.
Thank you. Batley first from 1981. That is Pretty in Pink. Good evening, welcome to the Xclusiv. You've got good taste.
This one's dedicated to all you Gucci bag carriers out there. It's called You Got Good Taste.
I Yeah.
that's Glenn Miller.
Thank you. of the place, and it's lovely to see Charlie Williams down here. I believe you've met one or two people in here before, Charlie. Bye. On the circuit. Have you, lad? Yeah. You've met them all personally, have you? Majority of the people in here,
yes,
because
I don't miss much.
They're not your sort of scene, really, are they? You know?
Yes, right. Jobs are good.
Jobs are good. You've met Peter before, haven't you?
Yes.
And you've met Annie. Where did you meet Charlie
before? When the variety club was going, before it was the Frontier.
Yeah.
We met, it's about 8 years ago, isn't it? 10 years ago, maybe.
Yes, I'm older than when I look.
And you've met Charlie before,
yes,
haven't you?
I met him before.
Where have you met?
At the variety club.
Oh, yeah. And you've never been down here? Did he come down here before it was changed?
Yeah, I haven't missed many places at all, Howard.
No. And what about you, Peter, then? What do you think to the places it's going now? All right?
All right, yeah.
It's going all right?
Yeah, we're doing well. Especially this crowd
in my... Yes, we're doing quite well out of it, yes.
Sorry about that.
I'm not cracking any jokes.
No, it's like that, it's Howard. He will ogle the mic. He can't get a word in.
In his own mouth.
Yeah, well, I didn't expect all this coming here. Anyway, Annie, come on, say a few words anyway today. What's this party all about, anyway?
Well,
tell them why we're doing it.
Well, we're doing it just...
For your regular customers.
Yes, for regular.
For your regular customers, and you're giving them a bit of a do, like, you know what I mean?
Well, we did. In probably 10 years' time, we can look back and say, well, look, that was our club if we're not here then. And
also when the fashions change and they can see themselves as they are today.
Well, this is it.
Yeah.
Well, when we came here, we didn't expect anything like this, did we, Shelley?
No, I think when the fashions change, we'll be gone. Yeah.
We'll be dead and gone, you know. Well, Peter's a lot older than us two, you know.
I
mean, he's knocking on a little bit.
You wouldn't think so, would you?
You wouldn't. I mean, I don't know what she sees in older men.
No, I agree with you.
Thank you, Howard.
Yeah, Rod Stewart's got a bigger nose than me. Rod Stewart's got an extra 3 inch on me.
Oh. I wish I'd have brought my dog.
Your dog?
I was going to bring my dog, but trouble is I have trouble with him, you see, because he's black. Because he's a Doberman. And he's German. Obviously, and they don't understand English because every time I say sit, I have to clean up after him.
Is that all right for you? All right.
Yeah, lovely. I can get back to my dancing now.
after Charlie Williams, we'll get back to some dancing.
Thank you.
greatest prisoner of love. This is the day.
Change all my new world. Couldn't buy that door.
1982, that is Living on the Scene, and this is the birthday party, and release the band. Anybody's got anything nice to say about the Xclusiv, now's your chance.
will be.
And yours?
Deborah Stratton.
Right, and are you both working or unemployed or what?
Well, I'm working.
You're working? Where you work?
Well, believe it or not, I'm a nurse.
You're a nurse? Yeah, where?
Dewsbury.
And what basically does that involve?
Well, I'm still training at the moment, so I work at Batley, Staincliffe and Dewsbury hospitals. I'm on casualty at the moment at Dewsbury.
Yeah, and are you working?
Well, I'm a part-time student and I'm unemployed besides that. I'm doing A-levels.
Yeah, okay. Where'd you get your hair done? You know, do you get it done specially at any special place, or do you do it yourself, or what?
We do it yourself, really.
Yeah, I've got a friend who cuts my hair.
And what about all your clothes? Do you have to buy them at any special shop? Would you go to a certain shop or?
I make my own clothes.
Sorry, can you say that again?
I make my own clothes.
And what about you?
Well, get some made, and then you just look around for whatever you fancy.
So what, you just basically buy what you want, if you see it, you buy it. You don't go anywhere special to buy your clothes or whatever?
Well, not really, no. Jumble sales are pretty good.
Yeah, second-hand shops.
Yeah.
So you go to a lot of jumble sales and second-hand shops to pick up that style of clothing?
Yeah. Oxfam's all right.
Oxfam. Yeah. And what sort of music? What's your favourite type of music, your favourite records?
Oh, no, I don't know, really. It's
whatever the playing.
Quite vast, really.
Yeah, can you just give us one or two?
Well, like Glenn Miller. That sound, and dear me, Cabaret Voltaire.
You say you like Glenn Miller, it's a bit out of date, really, isn't it? You know, what makes you go for that style of music?
Oh, no, it's quite good, it just inspires you. It's,
you think it's good music, you know, it's got a good melody to it, because to be honest with you, I don't know a lot about that type of music. Now, as far as I can gather, most of it hasn't got much of a melody to it or much of a beat or whatever, like, you know, but I suppose that's sort of complete different from a lot of the other stuff he plays.
Well, yeah, it's just whatever gets you, isn't it, what you like. But I know, you just like it.
Yeah, and what about you? What's your favourite records, favourite style of music?
Well, basically what they play here is quite good. It's wide variety. I like Glenn Miller. It's nice to listen to and dance to him.
And what do you think about it when he, you know, plays stuff like the Monkees theme and that sort of stuff?
It's good fun, isn't it? It's nice to dance to him. It's a change.
I think it breaks the evening up a little bit, you know. Yeah. It creates sort of a party atmosphere more than anything.
Yeah, you can't do just one sort of music. It's no good at all, really.
Okay, right, thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Okay.
Einstein.
And you work as a reporter, you say. Where's that for?
For the Dewsbury Reporter.
Right, now, your hair's not as bad as the last two, but where do you get your outfits from?
Oh, mainly in Leeds, but sometimes I just shop around and just take whatever takes me fancy.
And do you go to any special shops?
Not particularly, no. I know, I'm not really bothered about which shops I go to at all.
The other two said they got a lot of the stuff from, like, jumble sales and Oxfam shops. Do you get anything from that?
No, I try not to, know, but if something takes me fancy on a second-hand stall, I'll buy something, yeah. I like doing second-hand stalls, actually.
Yeah, okay. Let's go on to the dancing. You know, what sort of records do you like to dance to? What sort of music do you like?
I absolutely love David Bowie. He's my favourite. But I like T-Rex, Cotton Rebel, all the older sort of artists.
Yeah. What's your favourite Bowie single? Because I like Bowie myself, actually.
Well, my favourite one to dance to is Amsterdam. But I like his current single, Blue Jean, especially.
Yeah, okay, and where did you learn to dance like that? Because it is fairly good.
A lot of people ask me that, but I just taught myself. I went for a few jazz dancing lessons at Leeds, but I didn't keep that up for very long, but I just make it up, stand in front of the mirror dancing, watching myself.
Yeah, because it does look very effective, doesn't it?
Yeah, well, a lot of people have commented on it, but I just go out to enjoy myself and get on the dance floor. I just lose myself in the music.
Yeah, I suppose it's the best way to go about it. Yeah, okay. Anything else about this? You know, what records you like? What sort of music you like?
Well, I like something that I can... Well, I love miming. Well, it's not really miming, but I just love something that I can move well to. And I like a lot of the disco records as well, especially a lot of the with a good beat.
Yeah, because I suppose a lot of your dancing is a form of mime, isn't it? Especially some of the David Bowie records.
Oh, yeah, most of it is, yeah. I just absolutely love miming and getting on down there.
And so you actually took a couple of dancing lessons?
Well, when I was little, I took ballet lessons, but I mean, that's a long time ago. So I did a jazz class at, I think it was just the Yorkshire Dance Company in Leeds. Yeah, I've taught quite a few things. It comes in handy for blue jean, jazzing for blue jean.
Yeah, I can imagine. Okay, right, thanks ever so much.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Bye. Any of your names?
Michelle Lacey.
John Bennett.
Nancy Telsney.
And do you work or unemployed or what?
I go to college, Huddersfield.
Unemployed.
Sorry?
Unemployed.
Huddersfield.
Right, now, I've asked the other people I've interviewed. Could you tell me about your clothes, your style of dress, where you get the clothes from?
Mostly second-hand places and stuff, and mostly I make them myself.
Yeah, some of the others said they got them from Oxfam shops and jumble sales, that type of place. Is that right?
Yeah, it's the most original places there is for clothes.
Yeah, and is that the same with you?
Yeah, buy dresses and cut them up and just do anything with.
Well, so actually buy dresses and...
Second-hand dresses.
Yeah, okay. And your outfit's a bit unusual, to say the least. Did you make it yourself?
Yeah, I made it off a sheet off her bed.
You made it out of a bed sheet?
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's
okay.
Where I get all those clothes from. My sheets.
And your hairstyles, do you do them yourself or do you get them specially done?
Well, I went to an hairdresser's and they didn't cut it how I liked it, so I just do it on my own way.
Well, so they didn't cut it how you wanted it to be cut, so you spiked it up like that?
Yeah.
And what about you?
I worked at that hairdresser's. I didn't do it. I got sacked the morning she came in for an hair doing.
It wasn't you that cut hair, was it?
Me. I would have done it. I'd have made a better job than what other woman did.
Yeah, okay. And what about you?
I was supposed to be doing my hair, but it got sacked, so she did it, and it was awful. I had to do it myself.
So you was working at the hairdresser's and you got sacked because someone cut her hair badly?
No. I got sacked the morning that these two were coming in for the hairdo. And I was going to do the hair, but she sacked me, so she did the hair and made a mess of it.
So that's why you got a hair cut now, you didn't want it to be cut?
Yeah, it
did. OK, now what sort of music do you like? Obviously you like this alternative style of music, but in particular, could you sort of make it a bit more specific?
Smiths mainly, and Echo and the Bunnymen, stuff like that. Oh, generally, just... No particular taste, just absolutely out. Just depends.
Well, I like Alien Sex Fiend and the Specimen and the Cramps, Birthday Party, Virgin Prunes, Oatreal Pumpkin.
Stranglers, Soft Cell, things like that.
Now, a couple of the others were saying they like Glenn Miller. What do you think? So the Glenn Miller, I know it's about 30 years out of date, but what do you actually think to it?
She drags me up to dance. I don't like it at all.
No, I don't like it. Don't agree with me at all. It's just terrible. It really is.
Okay, right. Thanks ever so much. Okay. Well, anything you want. I mean, what makes you come to this club?
Because I get drunk and then I come here and I just enjoy myself.
So enjoy yourself. Do you enjoy the music?
Yeah, of course I do.
You enjoy the music. I mean, I've seen you get up and dance a few times, not so much tonight, but
no.
You do usually get up and have a bit of a laugh.
Of course, yeah, great. It's great, yeah. I mean, as you say, I just haven't come here. I've just actually walked in tonight.
I know you come here quite regular.
Yes, I do.
And is it... Well, what is it about the club that you think is, you know, the best thing about the club?
Well, the music, really, yeah, the music.
What about the people, the company you meet in there?
The company as well, is quite good, yeah.
Yeah, okay, right, thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Right, I know your name already, it's Kat. What do you like about this club?
My friends, music.
After I was drinking.
I don't know.
No, they don't do after hours, I can vouch for that.
I like everything, it's alright, it's happy for home.
You like the music?
Yeah.
And you like the company that
people,
you meet and the people?
Yeah.
And what sort of music do you specifically like?
All sorts. Absolutely all sorts.
Yeah, be a bit more specific than that. What are your favourite records that they play now?
Psychedelic Furs.
Yeah, okay. I don't know any records by them myself.
Look my way.
And what about your clothes? Where do you get them from? Do you?
Clothes?
Yeah, do you go to a specific shop?
Xclusiv in Leeds.
Sorry?
Xclusiv. It's Linda.
Linda. Okay, now, where do you get your clothes from? A lot of people say they get them from places like Oxfam and Jumble Sales. Now, is this true?
No, I make all mine. I make them out of sheets.
You make them out of sheets. It's funny because somebody else was saying they did exactly the same. Now, your hairstyle, it's a bit unordinary to say the least. Do you get it done specially or does someone do it for you or what?
No, I do that myself as well.
You do your hair all yourself?
Apart from the sides, I get that done at a barber's usually, that's about all.
Just the sides at a barber's and you leave the top for yourself?
Yeah, that's right, I just do that.
Now, what do you like about this club? What do you like about the music? Which music do you like and whatever?
I don't know, I just like it because it's different. It's the only place around here that plays this sort of music, so it's quite good really. I mean, there's not many other clubs that will let us all in anyway because they don't like us, so this is the only place where we can get our sort of music played.
Yeah, and what type of music do you like? Obviously, you like the alternative style of music, but could you be a little bit more specific about it?
I like the Stranglers, Cabaret Voltaire, Sisters of Mercy, that sort of music. I like most of the stuff that play here, really.
Yeah, okay, right, thanks a lot.
Thank you.
flute and vice viola. Thank you. gang children, Maritia Mayer.
Thank you.
Batley and the Wiggle. That's just about it from me. I hope you've enjoyed yourselves on a rather different Sunday. All right, make sure you get home safely. I'll see you next Friday. Thank you.
Hey, here we go. Brilliant dancing, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
As a customer, how did you enjoy it?
It's been really great, thank you. Yeah.
Good.
It's been fantastic, yeah. We've had a good night.
Yes, we've all had a really good time. It's been really nice.
Thank you very much.
Right. Yeah. Good
night.
Bye.
Peter?
Stay back a minute.
Lock it up.